Shaw and Partners is David Bosio. David, good morning.
Morning, Andrew. How are you today?
Very good, David. Look, strong start here to the new financial year and a real crank up as far as IPOs. What are you seeing?
Yeah, we've seen just an absolute flurry of new issues hitting the market. And, you know, I think it's a good and bad phenomenon because we've seen so much demand for new product. And the bad part is it does tie up a lot of investor capital. So IPOs do take typically a number of months to arrange investor subscriptions for stock, and then the money goes into IPO accounts, and then there's a process to then bring them on. So typically an IPO will tie up money for somewhere between 2 to 3 months for a lot of retail investors. So I think that often can be a drain on capital in the market. But what we're seeing is, and really, I think end of June and certainly into July, there's been multiple IPOs hitting the boards almost every day. So we're seeing a lot of new issues and a lot of new companies joining the ranks of new companies on the ASX.
And a good number of companies here raising cash too. Mako Gold this morning, 10 million. You were involved recently in Matador Mining's raise, 16 million.
Yeah, that's right. So Matador, a very, very interesting company. It's one that Shaw and Partners cover with some pretty strong research, and we have a buy recommendation on that stock. And it's a very, very interesting part of the world they operate in. And Matador is in a small island in North America off the coast of Canada, which is called Newfoundland. And for those gold bulls out there, everyone is familiar with a chap called Eric Sprott. And if you Google Eric Sprott, Newfoundland, you'll find that, which is actually pronounced Newfoundland, spelt Newfoundland, you'll see that his views on that part of the world is it's a big island in the middle of nowhere that is pretty much one big heap of gold. And they've made some pretty big bets on some gold explorers. Many of them are listed on the TSX, and they have very, very large market caps in comparison to Matador. But it is a very, very exciting province, and there's some big deposits being found. So we're pretty excited about Matador, and their exploration's been very successful. Fantastic team of very credible miners and guys who have run successful gold companies in the past, and they're in a very prospective part of the world. So they're doing the work, they've got money in the bank. If they do the exploration and have more discovery success, watch this space. It's a very, very interesting one.
And we know you're a gold bull yourself, so must be pleased to see it back above 1800.
Yeah, I'm almost frightened to make a call on the sector, because every time I open my mouth, gold does what it does best, and it makes me look silly. But it is starting to firm up again. We saw just a bit of a manic sell-off when there was this whole inflation, let's call it that real communications from the US coming out around inflation and whatnot. It sort of spooked the market a little bit. But, you know, we still, and I say this and I've said it many times, so I apologize for repeating the same message, but gold is linked to real interest rates, and you have to keep an eye on what real interest rates are doing. And although we're in an environment of inflation and potentially rising in interest rates, you have to look at the real number, and that's key. And based on our analysis, our view is gold should be trading somewhere between 1900 to 1950 at the very least, which also means that a lot of the gold equities themselves are probably undervalued at the moment. So when you look at it from a value matrix, you always start with the best, and you look at companies like, I guess, your Evolutions, your Newcrests, your Northern Stars. You can come down a tier, perhaps, the stocks like Ramelius, Silver Lake, they all present themselves as emerging and mid-tier producers. And then you've got, I guess, your smaller stocks for a little bit more a little bit more excitement in the marketplace. Stocks like Matador, etc., who are out there trying to become the next serious players in the production space.
Good to catch up, David. Thanks very much.
Great. Thanks, Andrew.